Hey, what's up, Katie?
Hi again. What's up? Well, today our focus is on this expression. Let's start by observing the conversation between these two birds. When one bird says, "What's up?" how could the other bird respond? Which of these could be appropriate responses? What's up? I'm great. How about you? Not too much. I'm just waiting for a coffee. The coffee I ordered 30 minutes ago still isn't ready. So more than one choice is appropriate, but not all of them. Keep following me on the path, and you'll find out which ones you can use and why. So first, can we answer what's up by replying what's up? Yes, we can. At times, what's up is used simply as a greeting, like hi or hey. It's often used like this when we are greeting someone we know as we pass them. But we can also respond this way to begin a conversation. Note that the pronunciation of what's up can vary. We may hear what up without the S, like this. Hey.
What up?
Or we may hear the even shorter version of sup, like this. What's up?
Sup.
Okay, well, let's continue and discuss those other options that we saw at the beginning. But first, if you'd like to see more videos like this, please take a moment and subscribe. So next, let's remember two of our other options for responding to what's up. I'm great, how about you? And not too much. Only one of these is correct. Which one is it? Before answering that, let's divide opening questions for conversations into two groups. In the first group, we have, how are you? How's it going? And how are you doing? The second group contains what's new, what's happening, what's going on, and what's up. What's the difference between these two groups? One group contains how questions, while the other group contains what questions. The first group of how questions requires someone to evaluate their state of being. Responses like okay, great, wonderful, and not bad work here. On the other hand, the second group, the one containing what's up, asks someone to give details about current or recent activities. To respond to these questions, you can indeed talk about what you're doing at the moment. Such as our earlier choice for this scenario, I'm just waiting for a coffee. Sometimes, though, people will just respond with something along the lines of not much, nothing much, or not too much. This is often just a routine response. And later in the conversation, they'll share more details about what's happening with them. So to conclude, we cannot answer what's up with I'm great. Not much is a better response. The last choice from earlier was the coffee I ordered 30 minutes ago still isn't ready. Is this an appropriate response to what's up? Yes, in the right situation, it can be. Sometimes, when someone asks what's up, it's to request an explanation. What's up can be used in this way towards someone who has indicated in some way that they have something to explain. This indication might come through something that is said. In this case, for example, one bird might have said, "I can't believe it," and then the next responded with, "What's up?" to find out more. Other examples of expressions that might prompt this use of "what's up" include, "Can I ask a question?" "I have a problem," or "I'm so confused." At times, instead of something spoken, it's a gesture or other nonverbal signal that indicates that someone has something to explain. For example, if one bird is looking unusually upset, the other bird might ask, "What's up?" In summary, of the 5 choices that were given at the beginning, 4 can be used in response to "What's up?" If the speakers are simply greeting each other, answering back "What's up?" is appropriate. When "What's up?" is used to begin a conversation, you can respond with an expression like "Not much," or with something related to what you're doing at the present moment, such as "I'm just waiting for a coffee." Just be sure not to answer with something like "Great," as this is an answer to a different type of question, such as "How's it going?" Finally, when someone indicates that they have something to explain and then hears "What's up?" it's an invitation to give that explanation. "I guess it's time I got this bird her coffee." And then that brings us to the end of the path for today. I hope that this has helped you become comfortable using and responding to the expression "What's up?" If it has, please like this video, share it with others, and subscribe. Thanks very much for joining me today on the path.